the House of Commons by Daniel J. Towsey. www.scrib.com.danieltowsey. Hi everyone. I originally wanted to call this article Canada's House of Commons. For those of you who do not know what that is, it is Canada's federal capital parliament buildings in Ottawa, Canada. I did not title it so because I wanted everyone in this world to read this, for these important thoughts apply to all peoples of the world who want to be free and live a happy and common life. The House of Commons is supposed to be a very noble and honorable place of higher ideals, the place where truth, justice, democracy, equality and liberty for all common people lives and breeds. A place belonging to the free, common, decent people of Canada and the world. A place where common people can express their love for truth. As truth is the core of everything that has ever mattered in this world. Without truth running things, we are all doomed to a new world order of evil and darkness. Before I continue, I would like to make a point about this article. I am writing this article for the young people and for the older ones who may have forgotten or been corrupted by the corporation corruption of our new times, also known as the New World Order, communism. A democracy is supposed to be a place of truth and justice for all, a place where all common people can have a chance to pursue simple happiness. The House of Commons was created so that we, the common people, could govern ourselves by creating common laws for all, written in common language. Canada has adopted two common languages to do this. Canada is a French and English country. Unfortunately, the communist New World Order has taken over the creation of our laws and now creates laws in an uncommon language. This language is called legalese, rhymes with sleaze. The common courts of the land now communicate in a language that the commoner cannot speak or understand. As such, there can never be any common justice based on common laws for the common man or woman. The House of Commons is supposed to operate as a house with a huge living room. A secure and private living room which existed long before the corporation ever put that new digital technology of covert psychological propaganda and mind control box there, also known as television. Before television, the living room was the single most important family bonding room in a common human's life. A room where music, dance, love or tears were shared. A place where we bonded with each other. A room where the common people shared their ideas and feelings. A place where the human family love grew. A place to share your dreams and thoughts. A place that unified our people and our country. A room where we fought and adhered disputes where truth and love could flourish. Are you getting my meaning? So as such, long ago when Canada was a young country with grand dreams of truth, justice and liberty for all, and the preservation of our natural environment and wildlife, there came a need to build a big common house for all the family members of Canada to gather and discuss things. So we built Canada's House of Commons alongside the beautiful Ottawa River and across from the French town of Hull on the other side of the river in the French province of Quebec. The Ottawa River was chosen because it was a very important central location for commerce. The Ottawa River was connected to our Great with North and went all the way down to the St. Lawrence Seaway and on to the rest of the New World. The Ottawa River saw native people in their birch canoes loaded with wildlife skins, furs. These were used to trade with the white Europeans of the time. Unfortunately, times have changed a lot. Truth, justice and democracy have died and have been replaced with what I call corporate image. I will be writing an article after this one, entitled, Beware of Corporate Image. Unfortunately, Canada, and the common dream of democracy was doomed to fail because there was a secret society that was subverting all common dreams. This secret society is and was completely insane, for insanity can only exist where truth does not exist, for insanity is a result of one knowing no truth. These secret societies have flourished and taken advantage of the common people's trust and fairness. Secret societies should be outlawed in a free and open democratic society. Secret laws, secret government departments, etc. do not serve truth, so they are totally anti-democratic. Secrecy only hides wrongdoing and protects the evildoers. Don't ever be fooled into believing that we need secrecy to defeat evil. That is totally insane. The secret society's wealth has grown while the common wealth has been stolen. These secret society members have lived the good life at the expense of all the common good people. We the common people have lost our common wealth, and then we lost all common laws, then we lost our common sense. All that is left is complete communist corporate insanity. Welcome to the new dark communist corporate ages, where there is nothing in common with truth, justice, and liberty. For the new world order, secret societies knew it had to destroy all that we the common people had in common so it could take control of everything by the divide and conquer strategy. When the new world order put that corporate television in your private common living room, the family bonding was invaded. Now people are lost and disoriented. They have no more common bonds. As a result, our Canadian House of Commons is no more. It has been taken over by the communists. The new name for the secret society's communism is corporatism. Have you read my The Last Democracy is Dead? There you will get some understanding as to why all Canadian municipal, provincial and federal governments and our corporations. So I am now announcing that the House is out of order, for it is now filled with corporatists and not with common people. We need to send in the army of truth soldiers and take back what belongs to us all. Are you going to become a truth soldier in the war against the new corporate order? Remember, there is nothing democratic about the New World Order corporations. A Truth Soldier copyright notice. You are free to republish Truth Soldier and or Daniel J. Towsey. Articles in whole form only. You may take quotes from it as long as you provide a link back to the original article and you give attribution to the right of being a Truth Soldier. You are also free to print or email it in whole, only exception being corporations not allowed. Comments by readers. Red Pill says it say you're a man of extraordinary common sense balanced with a healthy sense of survival reality. The House of Commons.